Hey, it's Chris here from Style Factory, the go-to site for digital marketing advice. In this Semrush review, I'm going to look at one of the best-known SEO tools available. It gives you a huge amount of data on keywords, backlinks, domain authority, and technical SEO. But like similar products, it comes with a fairly hefty price tag, so it's important to get a good understanding of its pros and cons before purchasing it. So, in this video, I'm going to spell out the key reasons to choose Semrush and the key reasons you might want to think twice about it. Let's dive in, starting with the key pros of using Semrush. 1. The reporting limits in Semrush are very generous. Semrush is very generous when it comes to the number of reports you can pull per day. For example, even on Semrush's entry-level plan, you can pull 3,000 domain analysis reports per day. This is considerably more generous than the limits applied by competing SEO tools. This generosity continues as you go up the pricing ladder. In general, Semrush gives you access to much more data than key competitors Moz and Ahrefs across all its plans. 2. Semrush gives you search intent data. A unique selling point of Semrush is that it gives you more context about why users perform searches than competing tools do. This is thanks to its excellent search intent metric. As part of the data returned by Semrush for a particular keyword, you'll see an intent box for it. This lets you know whether a particular search phrase is informational, commercial, navigational, or transactional. This data can be invaluable when working out which keywords are most likely to generate revenue, and other leading SEO tools don't provide it. 3. Semrush gives you really comprehensive pay-per-click data. If you're looking for a research tool that gives you data on both organic search results and pay-per-click, you'll find Semrush to be a great option. This is because its comprehensive advertising research feature returns a huge amount of Google Ads data, including keywords, ad positions, ad copy, landing page data, and more. Competing tools, including Ahrefs, do give you some PPC-related data, but it's much more limited in scope. 4. Semrush gives you built-in outreach tools. A key part of SEO involves reaching out to other site owners, asking them to create links to your content. Semrush's link building tool is great for this. You give it a URL and it returns a list of relevant websites to approach about backlinks. Not only this, but wherever possible, it also surfaces the relevant contact details for those websites. And on top of that, it gives you a built-in CRM style tool to manage the whole outreach process. You can connect this to your email account and do all your link building directly within Semrush. The platform is fairly unique in giving you such comprehensive outreach tools out of the box. 5. Semrush gives you access to a generous free trial. Semrush gives you access to all its key features and data as part of a free trial. Not all key competing tools are as generous here. For example, Ahrefs and Majestic don't offer free trials at all. Normally speaking, the Semrush trial lasts 7 days, but if you know how, you can get your hands on a 30-day trial, which effectively gives you a huge amount of SEO data for free. We've put a link to one of these extended trials in the video description and the video comments, but please note that this may be available for a limited time only. Okay, so that's 5 reasons we think that Semrush is a great choice as an SEO tool. But what could it do better? I'll come to that in just a moment, but before I do, I'd like to invite you to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and hit the notifications bell. This helps us out and gives you access to all our SEO content going forward. Okay, so let's look at the key cons of using Semrush. 1. You only get one seat on all Semrush plans. Semrush restricts you to just one user account per subscription, even if you're on its most expensive plan. Although you can buy additional seats, doing so isn't cheap. Competing tools like Moz and Ahrefs are more generous here, giving you more user accounts as you go higher up the pricing ladder. 2. Semrush only gives you search data from Google. Unlike some competing products, Semrush only lets you access Google data. Now, to be fair, given Google's dominance of the search engine industry, this will be fine for most users, but there are occasions when you might find it handy to get search data from services like YouTube or Amazon. Competing product Ahrefs is a better option for that, giving you access to data from 10 different search engines, including YouTube, Amazon, Bing, and Yahoo. 3. The limits on the number of domains you can work with could be more generous. As part of a Semrush subscription, you can only work with a set number of domains or projects, and the limits involved could be more generous, particularly where the entry-level plan is concerned. If you need to work with a large number of domains, there are better options available, not least Ahrefs, which lets you work with an unlimited number of domains, so long as you can verify ownership of them. 4. The add-ons can work out expensive. Semrush offers some very useful competitive analysis, local SEO, and agency add-ons. However, these can be expensive to use. For example, the Semrush Trends add-on, which gives you competitive intelligence on the traffic levels and marketing strategies of other websites, costs nearly twice the price of Semrush's entry-level plan. And that's it. Our take on the key pros and cons of Semrush. I hope you found this video useful. If you'd like to try Semrush out, there's a link to an extended trial in the video description and comments. There are lots more pros and cons of Semrush to discover, however. If you'd like to learn more about these, do check out the full Semrush review on the Style Factory website. There's a link to this in the description and comments too. If you enjoyed this video, please do support us by subscribing to our channel and hitting the notifications bell. And finally, if you have any questions about Semrush or SEO in general, do leave them in the comments section. We read them all and we'll do our best to help.